Hello, subscribers. I'm Sam Young-hong, and the Dean of the Korean Admission Agency Academy at Gangnam, Seoul. Today, let me explain about the atmosphere of the Korean universities crowded with the foreign students. So I will give you the information about number of foreign students who attend the Korean universities, and I do hope that every one of you will get high-quality information about the Korean universities. So the title is, how many students are attending the Korean universities during the year 2018? Not the graduate or PhD courses, but this analysis includes only undergraduate. So the contents are the overview and the overall analysis of the foreign students in Korea. There are some courses for the undergraduate coursework. One is the degree coursework, and the second one is the training coursework, and the third one is the joint operating courses. So there will be an overview for you, and the recent phenomenon, and the countries who send out their students to Korea, and what about the standpoint of the Korean universities, and there could be some side effects and demerits. And we have to think about the viewpoint of the Korean education and Korean economy. And the second one is the overall analysis. It includes degree coursework and training coursework and common operating coursework. For the undergraduate coursework, there are three types. That is degree, training, and common operating courses. So the first one will be degree coursework. So there will be an overall analysis for the degree coursework, and there are some departments or there are some categories for the degree coursework. One is the human and social sciences. Second one is natural sciences, and the third one is engineering course, engineering categories, and the fourth one is art and music courses, and the last one is the medical coursework. So these are the courses for undergraduate degrees. Okay, and the second one is what? The training coursework. There are three types of training courses. One is the language coursework, and the second one is the exchange study program. So there can be some students who are studying in Korea in return for the Korean students who are studying in their countries. And there can be visiting students and the et cetera coursework for the training course. So these are the training courses. And let's go to the common operating courses. We will see about the common operating courses. This course is very small, but some universities are operating the common coursework. And we will see the verbal capabilities for the how many members who get the Korean language certificate program TOEFL more than fourth degree or third degree, and about the TOEFL too, and the qualitative criteria, how much percent of the students who get the TOEFL or TOEFL degree. And we'll go to the dormitory system. So we'll see how many students are studying in dormitories in their own universities, or how many students who doesn't have their lodging in the universities or colleges. So, and we'll think about ratio of lodging at the university dormitories. So these are the summary for analyzing the title, how many foreign students are there in Korea during the year 2018? Okay, let's go to overall first. So what about the phenomenon? During the recent 5 to 10 years, Korean universities have admitted many foreign students. So the number of foreign students in Korea is increasing very sloppily. And the coursework is changing from the language or job training to the degree coursework. What about the countries who send out their students to Korea? The biggest part of the students are from China and the Southeast Asian countries. But nowadays, it is changing from the main countries to the other countries, including the North and South America and the European countries. Okay, what about the standpoint of the Korean universities? Yeah, they are advertising to their domestic students that they are globalized and they can offer some global atmosphere of studying all together with the foreign students. And the second one is, yeah, they are trying to escape from the restrictions of the Korean government. That the first merit for the Korean university is they can get students out of each number restrictions. Korean universities are not free to get their domestic students, but for the foreign students, they are all free. So they can give you so many admissions, as many admissions as they can. So, and the second one is, they can escape the limitation of the tuition fee charged on the foreign students. If they charge their tuition fees on their domestic students, they are restricted by the Korean government. But for the foreign students, they are so free. So this is the strategy of the Korean universities. They want to escape from the Korean government's restrictions. And the third one is, they are struggling against their difficulties in Korea. So they are preparing for the low birth rate. And so they are preparing the restrictions of the tuition fee. And some of the local universities in the Korean peninsula, they are trying very hard. But for the private universities, they have difficulty in getting the students, but the national universities located in local places in the Korean peninsula, they have enough financial support from the government. They are trying to be more globalized. For the Ulsan, they are located in the southeast part of the Korean peninsula. So for the private universities, Ulsan University and Ulsan Science Universities, they have some kind of decrease from 2013 to 2008, the students and the professors and the staff. So the number of students has decreased by 4%, and about the professors, by 10%, for the staff by 11%. So almost all of the people in the university have decreased. And what about the Ulsan Science University? The number of students has decreased by 8.9% between 2013 and 2018. And what about the professors? The number has decreased by 7.6%. So the local university in the Korean peninsula, they have difficulties in managing their universities. On the other hand, for the national university in the local area in the Korean peninsula, like the UNIST is also located in the Ulsan, the southwest part of the Korean peninsula, the number of students has decreased by 52%, but the number of professors and staff has increased very rapidly, 1.46 times and 2.13 times. So, we can see some kind of a bipolarization of the local university in Korea. And what about the other places for the Daejeon and Chungnam? It is the in the center of the Korean peninsula. And let's see the news report. The local university in Daejeon and Chungnam, they are struggling in getting the foreign students. Okay. The number of students at Daejeon Chungnam has increased by 30.6 percentage point. In Sejong, this is a new town, it has increased 3.7. So, as you can see, the situation in Korean universities, they have some crisis for their development, and they have also some kind of opportunity into world-class universities. These are about the Korean university officials. And According to the development, especially the increasing number of the foreign students in Korea, there are some side effects. The most serious problem is the increase of the students who has dropped their course before ending the coursework. We have to be worried about admission inspection of the foreign students. All right, and some Korean scholars like me, they are thinking of their Korean education system as a means of the development of Korean economy. So, one of the column, yeah, so written by me, is the advice for the government pursuing their policy for the structural reformation of the Korean universities. And we have to think about the Korean education flow. It is called K-edu, like the K-pop in the Korean music. Okay. I said in my column that there can be a lot of side effects because there can be many of the university staff losing their jobs and the reduction of the employment in local areas. And so there can be the depression in the local economy. And so the restructuring of the Korean local universities can bring about many social and economic issues. So we have to change our ideals for the university education policy. And so the staff, president and dean of the universities, especially local university in Korea, they don't have to complain about the Korean low birth rate, but they have to visit so many countries to get as many students as they can educate in their own universities. So the country can be the advanced countries such as United States or European countries, and the underdeveloped or undeveloped countries. There are so many students who want the Korean language and get the degree in the Korean universities. So they have to not be the scholars, but be the salesmen for getting the students from all over the world. So this was emphasized by me about 5 years ago. And if you learn soccer, or if you want to be a professional soccer player, then you better go to the country Brazil. If you want to get educated, if you want to get high quality education, then you better go to Korea. Okay. So there are thousands of childhood soccer clubs in Brazil. Like that, we Koreans, Korea has a lot of childhood, even infancy institutions for educating them. They are called in Korea, Hagwon. It is a private educational academy for training and educating the children and the students. They have the world-class and cutting-edge, the most competitive channel of educating their students. From the online education to the on-the-spot education, they are so competitive in educating and training the students. So the education in Korea is the same case with that of the soccer in Brazil. So now, the K-pop is really popular all over the world. There will be a time called K-edu. So there will be K-edu flow. And many, many students from all over the world will come to Korea to get educated by the Korean education system. That will be called K-edu. There will be more developed educational institutions in Korea. And so the Korean private education and the Korean public education will both develop. The former United States President Barack Obama said the Korean education system is the best in the world. So the secret of the Korean education system is Yeah, the Hagwon system, the peculiar Korean private education system. So many of the foreign students will enjoy the efficient Korean private education system, and by way of that, they can get admissions toward the famous universities like Seoul National University or Korean University or Yonsei University and many other universities in Korea. Okay. And so in conclusion, I said that we had to stop fighting between the private education system and the public education system. Instead, we have to be in harmony for creating the demand of the Korean education from all over the world. So we need cooperate among Korean government, Korean private system like we, or Korean public system. Then we can develop our Korean education system and we can raise the global education standard. Then these are the welfare of the all mankind. So these are the summary of my column written 5 years ago. Okay, now, let's go to the details.